Hey. John came home with a good idea. Gonna build you a brand new kitchen, dear. So he rebuilt the cupboards and ripped up the floor, smashed up the sink and rehung the door. Now it's 10 times worse than it was before. But anyone can be a handyman. Oh. Alex and his brother Paul put a PowerPoint in the wall. A simple job, no need for brains. They wired it up, turned on the mains. Now all that's left are charred remains. But anyone can be a handyman. If you've got a hammer and electric drill, you don't need money and you don't need skill. Do it for the fun, do it for the thrill. Anyone can be a handyman. Now Robbie had a roof that leaked, shook and groaned and flapped and creaked. So he hired a ladder and bought some tin and promptly caved the whole lot in. And now he lives in a caravan. But anyone can be a handyman. Let me tell you. And Richard thought he'd build a shed. He had the plans all in his head. He put it up and was proud to say it was built to last. But the very next day, a southerly blew the thing away. But anyone can be a handyman. And if you've got a hammer and an electric drill, you don't need money and you don't need skill. Do it for the fun, do it for the thrill. Anyone can be a handyman. Take it away. I like it, I like it. Here we go. If you've torn the lino, scratched the wall, chipped the tiles and flooded the hall, fallen off ladders, spilt the paint, nearly made the missus faint and seldom exercised restraint, well, you must surely be a handyman. And if you've got a hammer and electric drill, you don't need money and you don't need skill. Do it for the fun, do it for the thrill. Anyone can be a handyman. I said, anyone can be a handyman. One more time with feeling, anyone can be a handy person. Should have got a tradesman in.